Welcome to On Location TV19's presentation of Classic Suburban High School Boys Basketball. From Tartan High School, I am Johnny Kane, and we have a great Classic Suburban matchup for you here between two familiar teams. They're both part of our division of schools we follow, and it's Tartan, the home team, versus the Hill Murray Pioneers. Pioneers are being introduced as we speak. And shortly, the Tartan Titans, with a much larger fan line greeting their starters, will be next. Wow. In preparation for this game, I wasn't so sure what would happen, but I've learned from some fans in the crowd that Tartan has only lost one game this year, and they beat Hopkins. They lost their next game against Montemedi on a last-second buzzer beater, but they'll get Montemedi again, and they are excited to play the Pioneers. Looking at the starters, for Hill Murray, Jack Sitchie, Ryan Buron, Jake Christensen, Jerry Butler, and Stephen Mackley. And I watched them shoot in the pregame, and the Hill Murray shooters look like they're on fire in the pregame, but that's not with many defenders around them. Here's Tartan. And that's Xavier Hall, who was just introduced, senior guard. He has an offer to go to Morehead State University. I'm not sure if he's going to accept it or not, but he does have the offer. Maybe he's looking for more offers. And there is Michael Hudspeth, another senior guard. There's one big man center you're about to see for the Titans. He'll be coming up last. 6'8" center. Brody Jackson, kind of excited for that type of height. Hill Murray's just 4-5 overall, and like I said, Tartan's only lost one game. There's the big man. Oh, he didn't jump. He saved somebody from going that high. So there's the Tartan starters. 6'8", junior center. Wow, can you imagine if he has a growth spurt? He's capable of it. Xavier Hall, very good team here. Head coach Mark Klingsporn. Mark Klingsporn, very successful as a head coach. And been at Tartan pretty much his whole career. And I think he's had offers from other places, but he loves being at Tartan. And also the head coach of Hill Murray, longtime head coach Dick Gazzoni. Dick Gazzoni. Well, once again, I am Johnny Kane on Location TV 19. We already had our national anthem, so we're getting set for tip-off. Hope everybody sits down and enjoys this contest. Classic Suburban Boys Varsity Basketball. And look at the size difference for the tip. There's a Classic Suburban standings as they get set to tip. Montemedi, a girl in the crowd told me they're not very good. Well, they look good to me. 7-1. And there's the tip. Brody Jackson goes at it twice and gets to it. Sitchie couldn't even really get to it before Jackson had his paws on it. And now Tartan will have the first possession of the ball game. They're going to work the perimeter game. Remember, Tartan's always known for great defense. So if they start scoring here, it'll be a tough night for Hill Murray. And there's the first shot of the game. It's missed by Tartan's number 13, Michael Hudspeth. And here comes the Pioneers. There's an ankle breaker. Nice move there. And the shot's up and no good. Rebound to Tartan. Now Tartan's just going to work it around the perimeter once again, looking to get down to Brody, 6'8" center. And there's a deep three from the corner, no good. Rebound to Hill Murray. Ryan Buron brings it up. Sitchie misses. And it's going to go Tartan's direction. And just seeing a little earlier, as we have a 0-0 score, that Ryan Buron made a nice move when he had the ball and totally broke down his defender who was guarding him. But nobody scored yet. Some decent looks from both sides. Now Tartan back at it. Top of the circle. Down in the corner. Open shot. That one a little too strong. No good for Tommy Hansen. And the ball out of bounds. Tommy Hansen, a 6'4 junior forward for the Titans. We are at Tartan High School, and it's a pretty big crowd. Both sides have filled in nicely. Here's Jack Sitchie. Over to Buron. Braun sees a bunch of trees in the way, so he gives it back to Sitchy. Sitchy goes up against Brody. Brody says, get that out of here. Here's a quick break and 2 points. And Hudspeth is the first to get on the board. And the first 2 points of the game. There's some of that tough Tartan Titan defense, and it works out for the Titans. A steal and then a foul on Hill Murray's number 25, Jake Christensen. Well, the only 2 points of the game going to Michael Hudspeth, senior guard of Tartan. And with the ball right now, that's Kyrie Kirkland. They like to work it to the left side first in this offense, it appears. And there goes Kyrie, misses, rebound to Sitchy. Tartan up 2-0, and Hill Murray has missed all their shots so far. Ryan Burren, behind his back, kicks out. Three, almost there, but no good for Hill Murray. And then a quick shot by Tartan, and that one goes in. That one from Xavier Hall. So Xavier Hall with his first bucket, and then another steal. And here comes Kyrie Kirkland, and he loses it. Nice defense there by Hill Murray. Now bringing the ball up. Hill Murray not able to score here, and we're almost 3 minutes into this game. Sitchy will take it from the top of the key and drain it. Jack Sitchy, senior forward. Tonight, and there's a turnover on Tartan, but tonight it looks like Sitchy's gonna play center for Hill Murray. Remember, Sitchy comes from an athletic family. They all go to Hill Murray. He's the young brother, and he's a senior now, and he's a heck of a football player, and one of their main weapons in basketball. Drive, snuffed out, back to the top. Ryan Burren controls the ball a lot, but he's being guarded ferociously. There he has it, doesn't want to take that deep of a three. Tries to make a few moves. Hill Murray looking stagnant, and there's a steal. And it looks like the Titan was going to dunk it. He was hoping Xavier Hall, but he was fouled hard in the process. Mark Klingsporn looks on with a little bit of anxiousness, wondering what happened to his guy. Well, here's what happened, Coach Klingsporn. That's a hard foul. Only thing he didn't do is just drag him down. That's what I would have done, but then I probably would have been ejected. And so would he. And there was a technical, because here we go with Xavier Hall. Now he makes him pay already. There's one. He's got 3 points already in this game early on. Almost 4 minutes into the game. First half of action. Second one is good. Jerry Butler is just coming into the game for Hill Murray. Number 22. With the inbound from behind Tartan's basket. Kick it out to the left. Hudspeth gets it back to Xavier Hall. Hall looking for something. You know, so far we haven't seen him go to the center too much at all, actually. And there's Brody, but he's boxed out for that rebound from a guy who's probably about 5'5". Nice rebound for Hill Murray's number 31, Eric Weimer. Dangerous pass. Hill Murray retains. And here's the first look in the drive. And a little too strong there for Jerry Butler. Hill Murray gets the ball back, though. Tartan fans thought that they had it. And then it looks like we have a foul on Brody Jackson. Ansichi and Mark Klingsporn has given the ref a little bit of an earful early on. I suppose that's what you want for Hill Murray, to get Brody Jackson definitely in foul trouble, because he's a big man and he can get a lot of rebounds. There's a shot, no good, and the shooting is just ugly early on here. Jake Christensen missed that one. Deep three, off the front of the rim, no good. Rebound, Hill Murray. Up the floor, Eric Weimer. Weimer looks a little angry. Not a lot of movement out there for Hill Murray, and almost another steal. I can honestly say that Michael Hudspeth is playing some great defense. That's him right there. And there was almost a steal again. And here's a three from the corner, good. Eric Weimer, and he needed that one. Hill Murray needed that one. Tartan back to the top, swinging it. Nice play, they tried to get into Burton, but he kind of kicked it. And Hill Murray gets the turnover, and another attempted steal, but didn't go Kyrie Kirkland's way entirely there. And it was on Kirkland, that foul, reaching in. But you know what? That was a heck of a defensive play. I'd be a little scared if I was the rest of the Classic Suburban for the rest of the season, because this Tartan team not only has size and athleticism, it seems like constantly they just are great defenders. And Hill Murray. Only down 1 point. It seems like a lot more, but that three really helped for Hill Murray just a moment ago. And there's an inside drive. And a foul on Tartan, so the fouls are mounting on the Titans. Michael Wales got that foul for Tartan. He just checked in. Our new player is on the floor, and here's a deep shot. No good. Rebound, Tartan. Look at that drive, and it's stripped away in the lane. Nice defensive play there by Jake Christensen. And these two teams, neither of them have been able to get on a roll at all. Here's a three. A little too strong. Rebound to Tartan. Teddy Klingsporn. And a travel by Wales. Michael Wales, senior forward. Teddy Klingsporn. Well, he's obviously related to the coach. And we have a quick timeout here on the floor. 6-5 is the score. And boy, 7 minutes into this game, you'd think there'd been a little more scoring. But both teams a little cold. Mark Klingsporn obviously had his moment in the sun over 12 years ago. Tartan hit big in the high school basketball tournament. Tartan is no joke. They never are. I mean, you get a good head coach with a philosophy like he has, and he's very good at what he does. Dick Gazzoni has had a lot of success over the years as well. I mean, he's been there a long time at Hill Murray, so obviously everybody's happy with him. Does a good job. Hill Murray's gone on runs as well. More in hockey, but they always have a competitive basketball team, and their football team, I guess, is getting a lot better as well. So we're back into action, and Hill Murray swings it around the perimeter. Gonna go low to Christensen. Christensen's gonna take him on. Looked for a foul. Maybe he should have got one, but it's a rebound to Tartan on the miss, and here they come running. But the defense is on both sides, and Hill Murray not only swatted it away there, there's a tie-up, and the possession aerial goes to Hill Murray. So good job on defense there. Tartan not able to just do what they want. No scoring over the last minute or so of this game. And that's Butler bringing it up, and then he passed off. Down low, nice pass, and the bucket is made. Nice play all around there. Ryan Buren got the two. Wilmery had its first lead and still retains because they got the miss and they are coming back at you. Kick out, Burren. Burren not that hot. He missed that one, so rebound to Tartan. And we have a timeout. Mark Klingsporn and Tartan takes it as his team is now losing and gone quite cold at shooting the ball as well. Well, looking at Hill Murray's games played already this year, they are on a two-game winning streak. Now, they started off the year with a couple of losses, and their first win was over St. Paul Como Park. But then they lost right away to St. Paul Highland Park right after that. So they didn't do too well in the St. Paul City Conference. But then they got their big win in the conference over South St. Paul, followed by a couple losses, and now a couple wins. Their last win was over Milwaukee Bayview High School. Sure, that was a Christmas tournament. And here comes Tartan. Off the timeout. I think the coach wanted more energy. He's seen it. There's a nice three. Deep outside there. Nice play by Michael Wallace. Ooh, what was that? A pass? A shot? Couldn't quite tell, but Jack Sitchie was almost there, but he wasn't there. Now Tartan has it. Shooting a three right away. Maybe coach said, get off some shots, guys. Let's get some shots off. And that's what they've done out of this timeout. Ooh, a deep three for Hill Murray. Blocked! That one was blocked. Steve Mackley had his shot blocked. A lot of three balls lately for both sides. Tartan back on top. Hill Murray just had that 1 minute period where they led this game so far. Other than that, they've been down, and there's another shot. Xavier Hall. He's up to six. He's doing a lot of the scoring. Deep three. Made. Nice looking form there by Jerry Butler. Now we got a game going, 11-10. Both teams shooting it a little better since that timeout, basically. Down low, up high. Here's the three again. Arcing, nice shot. Xavier Hall going wild. We told you he has an offer from Morehead State University, and that's why. There's a shot. That was a tough shot. Missed by Eric Weimer. Ooh, and a little out of control there. Went Hall and turnover. Hill Murray had numbers, but it's going to be a one-man force here. Jerry Butler with the last 5 points for Hill Murray. And for coming off the bench, he's been a heck of a spark. Down by two now is Hill Murray. And here's another three. And made. And that one was Klingsporn. His first points of the game. 5-10. Hill Murray, about a 15-foot shot made from the baseline. Everybody getting in the act now. That's Alex Young. Missed shot there for Tartan, and boy, Butler has been all around for Hill Murray this game. And look at him, he's going to drive. He wants to go inside. Kicks it out. They might want to put it in his hands. And it's back in there. Here's Butler. Through the legs. Makes a move. Drives. Kicks out to Sitchie. Baseline no good. Rebound to the Titans. That was Klingsporn. Shot. About 15 feet from the baseline. That one's good. And now we have another timeout. And this one will be Dick Gazzoni and Hill Murray. So that was Tommy Hansen there with that nice-looking 15-footer. And Tartan, a three-point lead here in the first half. I'm Johnny Kane on location TV 19. Five high schools we follow, the Fab Five. Hill Murray and Tartan are both in the Fab Five. What that generally means is there's going to be an interview with the winners. Because when you play a non-conference team or one of our non-Fab Five and they win, a lot of times you just don't, you know, you don't see them ever again. And maybe you're just a little bitter. But tonight there will most likely be a winner's interview after the game. So stay tuned for that. 7:17 remaining here in the first half. Sitchie inbounds. And here comes Ryan Burren. Burren hands it over. Weimer gives it to Ogren. Back to Burren. Burren wants to stay outside. He does not want to drive in the lane too much. But look it, he just wanted to take a three anyway. Too strong off the back of the rim. And then, oh, Sitchie goes into the stands. And I'm not sure that the Tartan JV player sitting there appreciated that. That he landed on. Big student section right behind him and what just happened. Tartan, they know they have a good team. Ooh, all right. Oh, we have a little blocking there. Looks like Sitchie got that call. And Kari Kirkland called for that blocking foul. It looks like Kirkland's going to go off. He looks a little sore. Back in Xavier Hall, who took a little bit of a break. Christensen kicks out. Weimer. Christensen! I saw him shooting that shot from that exact same spot in pregame, and he was hitting a lot of those threes, but there he misses. Here comes Tartan. Tartan, of course, in the dark black and blue. Drive wildly. And this time, it's going to be back at you. A blocking foul on Jack Sitchie. And heading to the line will be Michael Hudspeth, who has only 2 points in the game thus far. But he's made his presence known with a great defense. There's one more. Leading scorer in the game so far is Xavier Hall with 9. This is Mike Hudspeth. He makes them both. He's up to 4 points. Kahari Kirkland's not really on the scoring sheet, or Brody Jackson. Jackson's back in there, the 6'8 junior. He's the center for Tartan. And we have a turnover on Hill Murray. And there's been a lot of turnovers so far by both teams. So maybe the halftime speech will get these teams focused a little more. We do have an entertaining one here, though. 21-14. Tartan starting to escape Hill Murray a little bit. And there's a steal. That's what Hill Murray needed. And it looks like this man's going to just go all the way for the layup. Weimer. He's up to 5 points. Out to Hall. Hudspeth. Kicked out. And that one made. Nice play there by Wales. He's got 5 himself. Oh, big block. There's Brody. And Tartan has a hard time getting the ball back, and it's going to be a jump ball, but it goes Tartan's way this time. But glad to see that replay, because Brody didn't even really get any air, but he surely swatted that one. There it is. Boom. He got a little bit of air. Look at him turn around. That was a little arrogant. I kind of like it. The ball was still in play, though. He likes blocking. Now he has the ball. They want to feed him. Kicks it out. Looking for an assist. And he got it. And there's Teddy Klingsborn. Big three. Shot up. Made. Sitchie. Kucichi doing something now. That's his fourth point. Shot made. What's going on here? Everybody's hot on both sides. And that time, it was Hudspeth with the three. Wanting to break him down as Jerry Butler hands it over to Sitchi. Christensen through the hands of his own player, but saved. Trying to break down Wallace, but Wallace going to go double team. Wallace, good defense, but not good enough because Christensen already had the pivot and the position. Nice job for Christensen. Ooh, loose pass there, almost stolen away, but Tartan retains. Looking to drive the line. Kicked out, Klingsporn over to Hall. Klingsporn says, I want it, but he won't make it. And rebound, Hill Murray. Ryan Burren filling up his stat sheet, more with assists and rebounds, but there's a miss on the open shot from Sitchi. Sitchi needs to get hot for his team to win, but look at that drive to the lane. That was impressive by Xavier Hall right there. He just turned on the Jets, and he made them look like boys, even though they are boys. Boy, we have a good game going here, and Hill Murray has really exploded on the offensive end over the last 2 to 3 minutes of this game. They are not missing, and Hill Murray just can't keep up with it at this point. Down 11. Hill Murray did have one lead in this game. But Brody Jackson, the 6'8 junior center for Tartan, I don't have him as scoring any points. One big block, I know that. Oh boy, I see one of the major subs for Tartan is Keenan Bellefant. And I remember him from the football season. You gotta remember a name like that. Keenan Bellefant. So we'll see him in here at some point. Good to be back here in TV 19 land. This is where I did my first game about 5 years ago. But it was Tartan Hill Murray girls varsity basketball. And that man right there, Jack Sitchi, was sitting in the crowd that day, probably as a little sixth grader. But his older sister, Rochelle Sitchi, was playing, a senior at Hill Murray at the time, and she's in the stands tonight watching. Here comes Burren. Burren making the move. Murray, not sure what they talked about on their last timeout, but it worked so far. As Eric Weimer adds another 2 to 7 points now. He's up to. Klingsporn. Over to Hall. Down to the big man. Brody kicks it out, though. And it didn't pay off that time. Long miss and long rebound. As Jerry Butler almost had it stolen away on the pass, but kind of surprised that big Brody Jackson didn't take it to the hoop on that last time. He didn't even have anybody really challenging him all that much, but he saw the open three and he opted for it. Hill Murray down by 9. Jerry Butler down to Christensen. Christensen can't stay in the paint that long. Kind of lucky he didn't get called. Miss and rebound to Sitchi. Sitchi takes on Brody Jackson, and Sitchi gets fouled. So Jack Sitchi will go to the line. Speaking of brothers and sisters, I can tell you this, that also Mark Klingsporn has had some kids come through here, including his daughter, who is a heck of a volleyball player, I can tell you that. She probably just finished up her college career. She got scholarship to go play volleyball for 4 years, I believe, at Marquette. Nikki Klingsporn. Sitchi misses that one. He didn't do too well on his free throws, and it's still 9 points. Got to hit them free throws, especially when you're down. Hill Murray almost has to play pretty perfect. They definitely are shorter than Tartan's, most of their team. Christensen's playing his heart out. Here's a drive and a nice ankle breaker, and then the shot missed, but there was a foul on it. So a shooting foul, and Xavier Hall will go to the line. And Eric Weimer will get that foul. Xavier Hall, I mean, we might have to throw a little highlight package together for him out of this first half. He's had a heck of a first half. Leading scorer, great defense, stealing. And he misses that one. Into the game again, Tommy Hansen for Tartan. And Xavier Hall goes for his second after missing his first free throw. Nice looking free throw. And he makes that one. Jerry Butler kicked it out. Steve Mackley didn't want to shoot it though. Mackley passes off. Trying to get it down low to Christensen's dangerous pass. You got to put some air on that one. Let your man put it behind the defender who was in front of him, fronting him. I mean, wow. Turnover Hill-Murray, and then, oh, no, now that's sick. He just threw it right into the Hill-Murray player's gut. Can't help get a steal there. And then a miss, and then a foul going for the ball on the rebound to Christensen. Boy, Hill-Murray is looking for to get on a roll. So we've had spurts of scoring in this first half, but a lot of missing. Xavier Hall wants to do it again. Well, that time, a little too strong. Rebound, Hill-Murray. Weimer gives it off to Mackley. Mackley kicks out. Shot from Byrne, and he gets the three. And a foul, 4-point play. It's the most exciting play in basketball. There's some people up here laughing at me, but I do love the 4-point play. If it happens, here's the replay. Look at that. He was wide open, and you can't land on the shooter. So Burren, he will make it a 4-point play. He had not scored since his first basket, and that was a long time ago, so now up to 6 points. It's a quick way to get back up there, though. 4 points at a time, that'd be nice. We're running out of time here in the first half, just 10 seconds. Xavier Hall, they just give him the ISO, drives the lane, puts it up, too strong, rebound Hill-Murray, and they better just toss it. He got it off. Oh, no good on the miss there from Eric Weimer. And that does it for the first half of action. I have to say, I'm pretty excited for the second half here. We have a game. It's only 6 points, the deficit. And both teams would probably say they didn't play their best game up to this half. But Tartan in control by six over Hill-Murray. And what we'll do is we'll take a halftime break now. So go get some soda or some chips. Come on back and watch an exciting second half on Location TV 19, Classic Suburban Boys Varsity Basketball.
I remember the moment.
I'll never forget that moment.
That moment?
It was a moment that changed my life. I'd been training with my team for months, and now we had been called up for the first time. The real deal. Wildfires were getting dangerously close to home. At that moment, I got my first taste of just how important the Guard is to my community.
See how the Guard can be an important part of your life at NationalGuard.com.
Welcome back on Location TV 19. We are at Tartan High School in Oakdale. Classic Suburban Boys Varsity Basketball. And it's been an exciting first half of action where the score is 32-26 in favor of Tartan. And the leading scorer thus far is Xavier Hall for Tartan, the senior guard. He's got 12 points. And we are back in action. Hill Murray, down six, needs to start making this a game, and that's one way to do it. Nice shot there from Steve Mackley for the three. Cutting the deficit right in half. And then a steal, Sitchy. He wants to go all the way, but he loses it. And then, oh, it's off Tartan. Lucky break for Hill Murray that time. And good effort from Xavier Hall to try to at least get that. His defense at least stopped an easy bucket. So now Hill Murray shooting on the opposite side of the court from the first half. That might help them. So far it looks good, but that shot missed badly by Sitchy. He's double covered, in fact. And then here comes Kyrie Kirkland down to Brody. Back to Brody. Brody, it looked like he got blocked, but it's a foul. Nice effort there to try to at least stop the easy bucket. That was Jerry Butler who got called. So Brody Jackson's gonna go to the line and look for some points. And he's still looking. I have Brody Jackson down with 0 points. And still zero, so he's not helping his team thus far. And Hill Murray just would like to tie this up and even pull ahead. We know that because Tartan can explode. There's a deep three. Off the front of the rim, no good. Rebound inside. Hill Murray gets it back. Offensive rebound. Sitchy gets another offensive rebound. Misses that one. And then Christensen missed it. Out comes Tartan. Xavier Hall. And he gets called for the charge. A little wild there on that break. That's his second foul. So we've only had 3 points here so far in this second half. By Hill Murray, Steve Mackley hit a three-pointer. And there's a steal. Can't go behind your back that many times. And then on the drive to the basket, the foul by Ryan Buran. I don't think they called it continuous, so he's going to go to the line for two. Big crowd here at Tartan High School tonight. Inbound. And back to Hall. Hall, obviously the leader of this team. But they're going to need Brody Jackson to step up his gameplay if they want to go deep and even get to the state tournament. Their section is never easy to get out of. And I hear Henry Sibley, the Warriors, are, well, they're back at it again with a good team. So this Classic Suburban will not be easy to win. And a steal by Sitchy. Good defense by Hill Murray in the second half so far. There's been no points scored by Tartan. Drive by Sitchy, takes on Brody Jackson. Jackson swats him. Sitchy's looking for some sort of foul, but he's not getting it. And then the drive and nice basket there. Made by Kyrie Kirkland. Christensen likes to shoot perimeter, but that time he takes it inside. And a traveling. I guess I would have to say, as far as people looking like each other, Jake Christensen there looks a lot like Nick Anderson, the producer of what we're watching here. I think they look somewhat alike. That's not ripping on anybody. I just think they look alike. As Hall has it, drives the baseline. And it looks like he was fouled on the baseline. Tartan will enjoy that foul. Now Kyrie Kirkland inbounds the Hall. Hall almost traveled by slipping there as he got it. Kirkland back. Does a nice pass over to the big man, and Brody Jackson finally gets on the board, and a nice play all around. That's on the highlight reel right there. Down to Christensen. Christensen steps back on Jackson and misses badly. Then the long pass gets up. We could see some excitement. No dunk, though. That's Mike Hudspeth. And there's a timeout from Hill Murray. Boy, I told you that Tartan, they can just get some quick points. That's the deal with them. Fast break, good defense. And what looked to be a close, tightening game has now got back to more than what the halftime deficit was. It was 6, Hill Murray was down, but now it's a good 9. Johnny Kane here on Location TV 19. Good look at the crowd. For an early January game, not bad attendance. Pretty decent day out today. Lots of sun, and really wasn't all that cold, so that's going to help people go out and do things. And Tartan High School, one very nice gym, and good spot to broadcast from up here where we do it. A couple perches above the court, you have to love that, because at some high schools, there's not this type of situation. A lot of times you have to sit on the court when you're doing the games, which ain't bad either. I like that too. But TV 19 brings you a variety of high school sports, including, we do both girls and boys basketball and hockey for boys and girls. And you see volleyball and football, and pretty soon it'll be baseball, lacrosse, and all that, softball. And we love volunteers, and we have some new ones with us. I heard a little younger, but they are learning the ropes. And we love our volunteers at TV 19. Get some camera experience, some on-air experience, editing, all that. On Location TV 19, good place to start. Tartan off the backboard, no good. Rebound inside. Tartan offensive rebound, another one. Put up, that time fouled. Mike Hudspeth fouled on that one. I have him for 9 points. He's going to try to add on. The offensive rebounding there really hurt the Pioneers. And you can see, if you really look at the size of these players, you can see just looking at big number 30 for Tartan, he's bigger than those two guys by half a head length or more. Then you mix in the great athleticism, great defensive prowess. Hill Murray really needs to do something big as Butler goes to the bench. And that one made by Hudspeth. Free throw shooting hasn't been that great from either side. Shooting probably about 50%. Both teams at free throws. Ooh, almost traveled there. Some fancy ball work and a drive in the paint and missed. Rebound, looked like it was Hill Murray's, but I believe it's on the line, and Christensen turns it over. Going for that hard rebound on the miss from Weimer. 39-29, 10-point gap. Just almost about 5 minutes into the second half. Hudspeth says, I like that spot. He really likes it. Nice little kiss. And Hudspeth is getting some points here now for Tartan. It's a pretty cool name. I like that, Mike Hudspeth. Deep three. Ooh, that was almost down, but the miss for Mackley. And here comes Kirkland. Kirkland thought he had a man to pass it to, but yeah. Luckily for him, it went off of Steve Mackley, still Tartan's ball. Ooh, 41-29. Tartan had 26 at half. They got the first bucket of three, and then they haven't scored since. This might be what Tartan's MO is. Play close and then really tighten up the D. Try to keep an eye on, ladies and gentlemen watching this, try to keep an eye on Tartan's defense now. They make it hard. You don't get a lot of open looks when you're the other squad. Keep an eye on that. Ryan Burren gave it out and a lucky pass to retain it there for Eric Weimer, and they eventually lose it. Oh, and then there's a collision. And it looks like Sitchy and Kyrie Kirkland had a little bit of man posturing, and and now I believe they both get a technical just for looking at each other. And Jack Sitchy's kind of saying to himself, well, what did I do? The other dude got up and walked at me in a kind of violent manner. I mean, not violent, but I don't know. That's nothing. And he, yeah, the replay cut it off there, but Kirkland, oh, that was a tackle. Jack Sitchy's a linebacker, I believe, for Hill Murray, and a good one at that. And I think he just wanted to play a little football for the moment. Third foul. That's third on Sitchy. All right, here we go. Upcoming games, Hill Murray, you got to check these guys out. Monomedi beat Tartan on a last-minute shocker, or last-second shocker. And then North St. Paul, Henry Sibley. Richfield's always a decent team. And then Simley. I think that Hill Murray's going to beat those Spartans there. And maybe, well, North St. Paul. I heard North St. Paul's pretty good this year. But Henry Sibley, good. And obviously, Monomedi, good. So all them games. Check out your paper or whatever. Go online and find it out. And go see some of these games. It's, I think, $5 or less. And it's pretty good action. I like boys basketball when it comes to high school. These guys are some of them men and some of them almost men. Oh, and I see Sitchy swearing. Glad we didn't have a camera on his lips there. And I don't know exactly what the conference is about, but it looks like Dick Gazzoni there is having it explained to him why his guy was called for that. I mean, he did the foul, of course, but the technical on Sitchy? Look at Gazzoni. He's, ooh. He looks like a basketball coach if I've ever seen. I mean, that is a basketball guy. Yeah, who... He looks like an old-school Hoosiers-type coach. Yes, he does. And he looks like when he gets angry, he's going to make you run a lot of Lakers, which are basically where you have to run to the free-throw line and do like 10 push-ups or sit-ups and then get up, go back, run to the half-court line, do it all over again. All right. Well, it looks like the discussion's over. We're going to get back to playing here as we had a break with some technicals. No free throws, so we're just going to inbound it. Klingsporn's going to do it. Klingsporn, also that's his son, but his dad's the head coach at Tartan. He's a little angry as well. I like that tackle, though. Ooh, that's what you got to do. Brody Jackson, look at that. That's all you have to do. Get it to the big man, and his wingspan is incredible, and he just laid it in. So Brody Jackson with another two up to four. And then a traveling on Hill Murray's Steve Mackley, senior guard. Nobody's really rotating in any subs so far this second half. This has been, Klingsporn just came in for Tartan, but basically there's been a lot of starters the whole second half so far. Oh, look at that. Oh, no. Oh. That's one you want back. That's the one that no matter what happens, you'll think about that tonight. As number 31, Michael Wallace, who has 5 points, was about to get the two freest points he's ever had. Couldn't handle it. Jerry Butler. Kicks out to Jack. Sitchy goes at the big man, and the big man once again makes life tough. Ooh, Sitchy still playing hard on the way back. Ooh, deep three. Off the front of the rim. Brody gets his big hands up there. And then a tie-up. Possession going with Tartan this time. .11:35 remaining. Hill Murray has not scored in a long time. They scored right away the second half to get to 29 on a three, and haven't seen him since. And there's a big three. That man just made up for his earlier pass mistake just a moment ago. And Michael Willis, nice shot, deep. And everything going Tartan's way at the moment. Christensen. Well, there's Xavier Hall. We haven't seen him do much in the last few minutes. Other people have been on his own team, but not necessarily him. Oh, look at that pass. You have to love that. Oh, and Jackson just lays it in again. I'm not sure why Jackson hasn't dunked yet, because he doesn't have to jump very high, but that was beautiful, and the pass was huge. We have Tartan upcoming games now to look at, and Richfield. North St. Paul Simley, similar to what Hill Murray has coming up. And then you mix in a little St. Thomas Academy. And Mankato East, wow. Mankato East, that will be interesting. I don't feel confident for Mankato East, and I don't even know anything about their squad, their nickname, or anything. But Tartan looks pretty darn good. And here's that pass. Look at that. No one around the big man. How does that guy sneak by you? And he almost went too far. But then there's that wingspan. Boy, I'm not sure if he has college offers. He grows another 1 or 2 inches, which I don't know if he wants to or not. Some people don't want to be 7 foot tall. 6'8 might just be fine with him. But in basketball at the next level, it's always nicer to be closer to 7. Jerry Butler, who went through a couple nice streaks in the first half, trying to get his team back in contention, kicks it out. Now Sitchy, gonna drive that baseline, but the big man was standing there in his way. Shot too strong. Rebound inside. Christensen had it, lost it. We have a foul. And I'm not sure it's a shooting foul. I don't think so. They're just going to throw it in from the inbound, as you've seen Christensen say, what? Boy, we just had a camera shot from down on the floor, and that Brody Jackson was eclipsing our shot. Butler. He would make his coach, team, and fans really ecstatic if he can score here, because it's been a drought, but no, a turnover. It's a foul. Butler quickly goes off the court and takes some seat on the pine, because I think he's up to 4 fouls now, and you know what happens with one more. He's out of there. I'm not even sure what he did on that foul, because he had the ball in his hands. Nice shot. Wow, this kid's exciting. Xavier Hall with another 2 and possibly a 3-point play. Well, we're good for also if you're a college basketball scout, because maybe you didn't get a chance to see Xavier Hall here tonight. But you're seeing him on TV-19 right now, and that's all you need to see. Guy's good. Look at that off-balance shot. Doesn't even fall. Most people would fall in that position. That looked, you know, last night I played boot hockey, and I fell from that type of angle he landed on his back leg, and I fell hard. But that's on ice. And here's Hall for the 3-point attempt. You know, he makes it, I'm thinking, you know, Morehead State, I think that they called a lane violation there, so it doesn't count for him. I'm a little angry about that, but it was on Hill Murray, so he gets another chance. But I think the Tubby Smith Show might want to check this kid out. And he makes his shot there. But also, Mark Klingsborn, the head coach of Tartan, has kind of a pipeline of sending players to Northern Iowa. Why aren't they not looking at the kid? His passes alone have been pretty exciting. And Hill Murray just keeps missing, folks. You think Minnesota has been in a drought, or Texas or whatever, the Midwest. Hill Murray's in the drought. They had 26 at halftime, and we had 18 minutes to start this half. So you can see 8 minutes, 3 points. Are you watching the defense at Tartan? Because that's what you have to watch. Look at that. No breathing there. Still no breathing. And a steal and a flop. And looks like Christensen was on the line when he was rolling around. In the meantime, Tyree Kirkland was sprawled out on the floor. Last time we saw him, he took a nice shoulder tackle from Jack Sitchy, and they both are on the floor, if you're wondering. Better get that inbound in. All right, Tartan got it in. 50-29. Wow. This was a game. Well, we have a turnover by Tartan. And Klingsborn, the head coach, even though he's up 21, he shouted something mean there to somebody. I know Mark Klingsborn. I've met him very many times, and he's one heck of a nice guy and a great coach. Oh, you can't pass it to the other team so blatantly. Here comes Kirkland. Kirkland lays it in for the easy bucket. I'm not so sure why Kirkland got up so angrily towards Sitchy earlier. I mean, it was a collision, yes, and it was a little intense. I don't know if it was intentional, but no need to get angry like that. There's the first points in a long time for Hill Murray, and Christensen drains it. Kirkland gets it down, an offensive rebound, and Tartan makes the bucket. It looked like that Christensen fouled Hudspeth on it, no call. So Hill Murray has two buckets in the second half, and both of them have been threes. Christensen with the ball again. Ooh, thought he had that one. Rebound into Tartan. I have a feeling at some point, though, that some benches are going to empty with not angry people, but substitutes. Hudspeth over to Kirkland. Kirkland drives. What was that? Jump ball. Possession Hill Murray. Boy, he went hard to the hole, but then I think he didn't really know what he wanted to do. Kind of thinking, what am I going to do here? A finger roll? Am I going to jam it? And he just basically got tied up. This man with the ball doesn't want any more fouls. There he goes. Jerry Butler. He's got four, I believe. Christensen has a few himself. And look at that. No time to think. A swarm of black and blue out there. Christensen doing a great job just to keep it alive, and then found the open man, and the three was missed. Rebound to Tartan. Nice job there by Thomas Hansen. And there's a deep three. We have a foul, it looks like, on Tartan off the ball. On the missed shot from Hudspeth. Uh-oh, look who's coming back in. He just needed a break for a half a minute. Xavier Hall. Back on the court. I tell you, I'm liking what I'm seeing here from Tartan as far as their future goes this year. They got a lot of experience out there as well, a lot of seniors. Christensen. Oh, loses it on the baseline. There was no foul, just kind of ran out of room. Christensen sits on the pine. I believe that Dick Guzzoni is a little frustrated, the head coach of Hill Murray, just because I think Hill Murray has had a total of at least 20 turnovers already. That's a pretty high number for anybody. Hall might want to double team him. Takes the shot, little strong. Rebound to Hill Murray. Nice job there of team rebounding. Burin swamped. Drive, kick, open three. Too strong air ball and out of bounds on Hill Murray. .650 remaining. Pretty sure this one's not going to be going to overtime. If it does, it would be amazing. I would love it because that would be some high drama. Hall covered by Burin. Goes down low. And that time, the player just wasn't able to maneuver. Jermaine Borward, his backup center, a junior. Borward. Tough last name to say. And Hill Murray goes for the steal. Doesn't even quite have it, but it looks like Hudspeth got it back, and there's a tie-up, so this time we'll go to Tartan. All right, so look at that. Can you fit Johnny Kane in the middle there somewhere? I'm just kidding, but that's one big chair. And they're sitting right on the court. Shot by Hudspeth, missed. And Butler, only 6 points the second half for Hill Murray. Both on threes. Butler fake, drive, kick. There's a wild running shot made. Michael Wallace. Actually, that was Eric Weimer on that one. Quick foul on Ryan Buron. He's got some foul troubles now as well. Xavier Hall to the line. Wants to add to his game-leading total. He does so far. Okay, I was just trying to read a sign in the crowd, but I can't understand it. Try to keep your O on. Somebody has a funny sign. Hill Murray, now 8 points. They really need to go on a scoring streak and to play some solid D, and there's a shot, no good. Rebound inside. Brody Jackson back in there. Jackson was calling for that one, but no need. His good buddy made it. That time it was Mike Wallace. Another three. That man likes to shoot the three ball. Got three of them tonight. Burton. And Jerry Butler missed and went for the ball, and back to Tartan. Did we have a foul on the play? Yeah, I think we had a foul on the play, another one. Uh-oh. Oh, there goes Butler. He is fouled out. Fifth personal, and he takes a seat right next to head coach Dick Gazzoni. Boy, those fouls happened to him in a way that I only saw two or three of them. I saw them all, but don't remember all of them. Especially the one he did on offense. I didn't see what he did. I was looking right at him. But that's why I'm not a referee. Hudspeth. And he's looking like Michael Jordan from the line. Those were nice free throws. There's an open three. And that's his mark. Nice shot there from Ryan Buron, who had a 4-point play earlier in this game. Now adds on a three. He's got a 2, a 3, and a 4. A for his scoring. And we have some new players coming in for Tartan. And that's Jarius Jubrin. Jarius Jubrin. Pretty interesting name there. Hall will take the three. Miss it. Rebound inside. Willis had it blocked. And here comes Hill Murray. And then a quick foul, it looks like, on Willis. No need for that one. Here comes the Pioneers. Oh, another one. Why not? Hit the last one, but that one too short. Rebound inside, and Hill Murray just can't hang on to the ball. That time, it was Alex Young. And would have loved to have that one back. Of course, we've seen the great Mark Sonnen play for Tartan, well, 3-4 years ago now. It doesn't seem like that long ago, but he's, I believe, a senior at Northern Iowa now, so it has been that long, and he's playing well for them. No, he's still playing this year. He's a senior. Saw him on ESPN about a month ago. Mark Sonnen's career has been pretty good at Northern Iowa, you know, coming from Tartan. And they did get to the, they beat Kansas in the tournament, NCAA tournament, his freshman year. But not really much since then. Will Murray's going to drive. Take a shot from the elbow. No good. That one, Eric Wehmer. Here comes Kahari Kirkland. That's the big man. Look at, try to swat that. He just holds it up. You're going to have to jump for it. Nice pass. Another nice pass. Kick, open shot. No good. And they had a foul called on Brody Jackson there before he actually even touched the ball. I think he pushed off inside. Brody Jackson will head to the bench. Jarius Jubrin made a nice pass there, looking to get an assist, but his teammate missed an open three. They're not gimmies. Looks like Hill Murray's going to bring in some more substitutes as they hit a three. And Meckley with another three. He's got two in the game. He hit the first shot of the second half for Hill Murray, and there's a nice steal. Nice spin move, kick out, open shot, and it's good. And there he is again. Steve Mackley. He's got 9 points on 3 3-pointers. And a quick foul, an unnecessary foul. And Ryan Burren is kind of arguing his case, but. And he's out of here. Fifth personal foul. Got to get your lunch and work pail when you play these Tartan Titans. I know that a lot of people from North St. Paul are definitely watching this game right now, and you're going to be seeing Tartan real soon. That should be a great matchup. And there goes Eric Wehmer to the bench. Got some new players in, including Alex Young, Alex Ogren, and the miss there from Kari Kirkland. Ooh, wow, deep three for Lingsborn. Teddy with another one. Drive, and there's going to be a foul on Tartan. So going to the line will be Steve Mackley. There he is. Just over 2 minutes and, well, it's 2:16 remaining. Game not in doubt at this point, 21 points. And you know, one thing I hate about like watching pro sports is a lot of the play, here's the drive, but a lot of play-by-play guys will not let you know that the game's pretty much over because they want you to stay with for ratings and all that. But the scoring 20 points here in 2 minutes and 16 seconds, I would say would be a miracle, an absolute miracle. I think it's impossible, especially when you can walk the ball up like that at your own leisure. Klingsborn, does he want to take another deep three? Maybe this man will. Tommy Hansen, down low, shot. Nice fadeaway shot there from Tommy Hansen. My athletic director and all that at St. Bernard's name was Tom Hansen, and he just passed away about a month ago. He was a legend at St. Bernard's, Tom Hansen. Good to see that name still going on. Nice pass. Whoa, Klingsborn from Kahari Kirkland. That was beautiful. Minute 20. Oh, look at that. All that free space. He couldn't believe it, and he missed on the shot, Alex Ogren. And it's still tough, though, when you got to kind of jump in into somebody when you're shooting and use the backboard. Not easy. So once again, if you want to become a volunteer for On Location TV 19 or just find out about the TV business and maybe come by, you can even produce your own type shows where we're located. Lots of stuff going on. TV shows and sporting events and concerts, plays. It's good that there's people like us and volunteers to help bring you these games. High school is sometimes the last stop for a lot of high school, or just athletes. And a lot of them don't go and play in college, and especially pro. So you're seeing it, and it's good for them. Spin, shot. Ooh, that was erratic and a heck of a shot made. Kind of like that from Jimmy Quirk. Getting on the board. And a foul on Hill Murray as a new Tartan Titan got into the game, and he's going to go to the charity stripe, and you have to love that when you just get in a game. Kylan Payne Jr. That's him at the line. Got the new man in for Hill Murray with the headband on. You got to love that. Jeremy Lambert. And the starters have pretty much disappeared from this game. This is when I usually got to play varsity boys basketball. When they cleared the bench, when somebody was winning or losing pretty bad. Get in there, Kane. It's your time to shine with 30 seconds. Ooh, nice move. This man looks pretty good with the headband. And then he dished it off. Miss inside. Rebound back to Hill Murray. Tough miss there from Chris Moore. But Chris Moore is just a freshman. Just a freshman, number 45, and he's pretty darn tall already. So I think you can expect some good things out of him over the next 3 years. He has a growth spurt. He's going to be devastating. 15 seconds. Pretty much the last shot time. They'll go down to the freshman. The freshman loses it. His teammate gets it back, puts it up, and gets fouled. Jamie Larmy will go to the stripe. Jamie Larmy. And down by 22, he would love to make it look any better. You know, there he does it. He's on the score sheet, too. This is the best job I've done at scoring in 5 years at TV19 because I've pretty much captured every point by every player. Usually I'm not doing that. I'm got a color guy who's doing that. Color commentators. And that'll do it for this game. It's pretty easy victory, 68-48. The Tartan Titans win on their home court and excite their home base as the Hill Murray fans stand up and they are ready to go. But it was a nice effort in a close game up to the first half, basically. But Tartan just pulled away. 68-48, player of the game would have to be Xavier Hall for Tartan. He had about 16 points. That's a pretty nice showing. And Michael Hudspeth had quite a bit as well. So we'll try to get an interview with the coach and a player or two coming back right after this.
Sure is a nice day for a ride.
I mean, I gotta go.
Traffic's a little heavy, though. If this person in front of me sees me.
I'll listen to this song.
I'm sure they see me.
What should I make for dinner?
It looks clear. Let's get in front of this bus here.
Maybe I should pick up Chinese. I don't feel like cooking tonight.
Okay, everything looks good.
There's something going on over there. Hmm.
They really gotta see me in that mirror.
Oh, I better get on the other side of the road.
Hey, look! Look out!
Look twice for motorcyclists.
Back with Coach Mark Klingsborn, and also Xavier Hall with the Star of the Game Award. You had a beautiful game, nice passing. What do you think of Hill Murray?
At first, in the first half, it was a very good game. They played with a lot of intensity, and they came out defensively pretty good. But after the game, we kind of opened up and moved the ball a little bit more, and we got a couple good shots.
Now, we were told that you had one offer from Morehead State University. You think that you keep playing like this, you'll get more offers?
Hopefully, that's what I'm hoping for, but no, it's just, we just got to keep working, so.
Nice passing tonight and also a nice off-balance shot. Coach Klingsborn, now you won the conference last year and you've been to the state championship and you won it. What do you think this team is like?
Well, I like our group of guys. They're guys that really play well together and they play hard, so they're the guys that have made a commitment to our program. They stuck with our program and they've done a great job.
And is Brody Jackson more a part of your offense, or are you more guard perimeter shooting?
Well, hopefully we have both. We'd like to have some good inside-out action. Brody's improved tremendously. He's only been his third year of real organized basketball, so we're trying to implement him a little bit more, but we actually have some senior guards that are really, really tough basketball players. So we're a little senior guard dominated, which is okay too, but we're trying to get some good inside-outside action.
Okay, last question. Do you guys think, just a quick answer, do you think you can win your section this year? I mean, I know that's jumping the horse.
Of course. Of course, no doubt.
That sounds like a true player answer. You know how coaches are going to always answer. I think we got a great shot. We just got to continue to get better.
All right, Coach Mark Klingsborn and Xavier Hall, thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Pass. Okay, no, launch it deep. A lot of down there. Can he catch up to it? He can. He's into the end zone. Touchdown.
All screwed together. It's kind of neat to see how we've all progressed.
Albert throws up the three. Good. Pioneers with a good opportunity. And another goal! Big hook. And a jab right to the jaw. And lights were out.
Tying the game up at four with this power play goal.
New school records from two freshmen. I want to remind you, anytime you want the latest and the best of Northeast suburban area in sports, tune into TV 19. You will get the best coverage. Don't forget that.